Here's the latest from Earth Now. This display shows the NOAA Climate Digest for September 2012. The Climate Digest summarizes noteworthy statistics for the month, season, and year. Although September was not unusually warm, the first 9 months of 2012 marked the warmest on record for the contiguous United States. Meanwhile, Alaska experienced its wettest September on record. In the tropical Pacific, the El Niño index remained neutral as the water temperatures in the eastern Pacific Ocean were only slightly above normal. Japan and Australia experienced above average temperatures. Australia experienced the warmest September maximum temperatures on record. While Western and Central Africa experienced heavy rainfall and flooding, Central Europe, including Hungary, experienced its worst drought in 20 years. The United Kingdom had its coolest September since 1994. In Argentina, September temperatures were the highest they have been in 50 years. Globally, the combined land and ocean temperatures for September 2012 and 2005 were tied for the warmest on record, more than 1 degree Fahrenheit above the 20th century average. This real-time data set shows sea surface temperature anomalies measured by NOAA satellites. Blue colors indicate cooler than normal ocean temperatures, whereas red indicates warmer than normal sea temperatures. In the eastern tropical Pacific, water temperatures are slightly above normal, but not warm enough to be considered an El Niño. The phase of ocean atmosphere system is called El Niño when temperatures along the equator are at least 1 degree centigrade, or almost 2 degrees Fahrenheit, higher than normal. Temperature anomalies less than that indicate a neutral phase, which is associated with average winter conditions for North America. This real-time data set, collected by microwave sensors on NOAA satellites, shows snow and ice cover updated daily. Watch the progression of days and note the changing seasons. In the northern hemisphere, the snow and ice extent begins to expand as it moves into winter. September typically marks the Arctic sea ice minimum. During fall, the warmer temperatures of summer give way to cooler temperatures of winter. The September 2012 sea ice extent was the lowest on record at 48% below normal. Meanwhile, in the southern hemisphere, the Antarctic just experienced a larger sea ice extent than normal. The ice is starting to contract now as its melt season has begun.